Push harder, push, push, push harder, push. Yeah. Yeah, one more. One again.
the mountains shake the spring thereof. There is a river, the stream whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High. God is in the midst of her, she shall not be moved. God shall help her on that right hand. The heathen raged, the kingdoms are moved. He uttered his voice, the earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us, the God of Jacob is our refuge. The hymn, when peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrow my sea billows roll, whatever my lot thou hast taught me to say, it is well with my soul. Let us sing together. Thank you. vicissitudes of life. We thank you, Lord, that even as we gather here this afternoon to reflect upon the life of our Father, that your presence is with us. We pray, Lord, that you will be with us in a manifest way. And Lord, as we go through this service today, our hearts will be blessed, our memories will be refreshed. And truly, O Lord, we will continue to look to you from whom our help comes. And thank you, Lord, for this moment. And thank you for those who have come to worship here today. Help us, Lord, that as we worship together, we will reflect upon your goodness, but also upon the mortality of life. And we commit ourselves, or commit ourselves, to your service and the service of your kingdom. Thank you, Lord, and bless us now, I pray, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Be seated, ladies and gentlemen. Let me welcome you to the service today for the life of Richardo. Pardon, I apologize, I have to start before I have the compliment of the other one, but time is of the essence and we have to move on. So I hope the persons for the tributes are here. Before that, is Aaron here? And we have Tashley present. I'm going to ask you to give your tribute to this chapter to my Lord, on the Lord level. And I guide for us to make our tribute as succinct, as short as possible, for we do have a limited time that we are working with, and I appreciate your cooperation. Thank you very much. And then we have Mahela Corbin. Is Mahela here?
Hi. Jesus. Like a sheep sailing out on a drift, so rough and long, and so far from shore, and so far from home.
right as we are at this time, and persons are transforming you. We need to be better. I'm sorry I have to say that, but it's on my heart, and I have to say it. Please write it down in your tribute. This morning.
Just as we have given us our praise in this house today, somebody praise the Lord. Somebody give us our praise. Hallelujah. He's worthy to be praised. Before I render this song to the family of Richardo, I would first say to my second mother, Sister Makala, my brothers, Dean, Prince, my sister-in-law here, I will say from my heart, I will give you my imperfect. Because your feelings or your pain is my pain, because I grew up a child in Sister McConaughey, and along with her children who are my relatives. I'm going to sing this song to you and just listen to the words, not the voice. Why aren't you feel so sad? Why does my heart feel glad? Why does my soul feel so happy again? To the family.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Come on.
We are the church of heaven. But we can do it. Good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon, Angeles. Good afternoon, everyone that is in front of me. Praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God. So, Pastor, Minister, I'm just going to ask you to bear with me. My job is not very easy that I will ask you to do. Someone has to just bear with me. I know that the time is of essence, but just bear with me. So, in memory of Richardo, my friend, my brother, my standing here just to give remembrance of him. There is so much memory flash to mind. I don't even write down anything because I know it like that. And so I'm just going to go off of my head top as the Lord will bring them to memory. So when we were a child, at the age of 3, I learned that Jaja, as we all know it as, was spending time at my home. And so we became friends from we were like 3 years old when Sister Makala, as we affectionately call his mom Jean, was about to go to Bahamas. And so she left Jaja with my mom to take care of Jaja. So we became good friends from then. So we used to eat each other food, we used to drink each other water. The only thing we didn't do was wear each other clothes. And so as we grew, as young children grew together, we knit together as brothers. As I said, he's like my brother. And so when we were growing up, you know, boys always be boys. We will fight. And we would fight, and we would do all these things together. I remember I was just like a skinny boy. You remember me? You remember that prince, right? Mr. Prince. And you remember when I was just like a little ant. And so Jaja was this big, fat young man, a young boy. And so when we were growing up, fighting. We were fighting together, and so whatever caused it to force to be fighting. Now, because I was so thin and he was so big, so he had more dominant strength and power over me, but I was determined. And so if he hit me on the left cheek, I want to hit him back on the left cheek. And so it would go on like that for days. And so, but because he was bigger than me, he was always saying to me, "Hey, like a boy, well, sit down, man." And so I was always up in his face to defend back whatever he has done to me. And so I remember he used to do something like this. You know what? I heard him, "Go on, man." I used to put him pushing me out, and I was always doing that. And so, as we fight, 2 minutes or 3 minutes after we fight, we would just start to play again, and we were best friends again. And I left my home when I grew up to be this young man, this young boy. Wasn't a man, but in my early 9, 10, 11 year about. And so every morning I would wake up and maybe don't do anything at home, but the first place I would find is GMO. And so we would be there as young men together, Prince, Keeble, Gina, Jaja, myself, Sammy, Barrington, Michael, and all these other young men that we were together. And so we called Jaja a name back then. We used to call it Balloon Shots. And so we used to have this blue shot, and the shot was so big, and then, you know, and we used to call it Balloon Shot. I can tell you, if you want your nickname to go away, when people call you by your nickname, just laugh like you love it. And so Jaja did not love Balloon Shot, and we would have trouble him with it. And so he would have fight us if we called him Balloon Shot. He liked to run. And many of us can be attested that Jaja loved to run. We used to play and we used to run around. We used to have our own sports in the community, DM. And I don't remember his name. It used to be our coach. And so we used to run around the road. I was a long distance runner. Jaja was a short distance runner. And so we used to run around. But you know what? One of the things that struck me as it relates to the Jaja and his brother Prince. Prince was bigger than us, and he used to be the one who used to say, we used to play karate together, as young men used to play karate together. And so whenever we go to the show house and we watch a movie, the following day we would replicate whatever we have seen in the movie. And so Prince would be the pop, and Jaja would be the star of our own attacking, and Prince would say to us that he would just use his one finger to fight us. And so he would use his one finger. Prince had this finger that looked so crooked. And if he stick it in your eyes, trust me, it's like something, it's like you're just blind. It's mostly your eyes that used to go out. And Jaja and I used to attack him. So one would come from the back and one would come from the front. And we grew to become this young man now that, oh my God, we branched off into this young man that we started to have our own ideas and philosophy and things that we want to do and where we want to go and the things that we would want to achieve and so forth. But Jaja was a girl's man. Jaja was a girl's man that I can tell you. I remember this young lady who we used to date when we were in Latoya. And so he would have steal Jean money just to give unto Latoya so that he could have Latoya to be his girl. And so we used to trouble him and tell him that all your money going into the steel room to just to give this young lady, and she don't want you. But after a while, about 4 years after, Jaja and Latoya became boyfriend and girlfriend. And we, as young men, you know, we started to do a lot of stupid things. And many of you know the stupid things that I'm talking about. We started to do things that I am not so pleased to even talk about at this present moment. But you know, being the person who I am, I can just be who I am. And Jaja would want us to speak the truth about it. Because even though many of us might see him in different ways, he was truthful. He was truthful. He would tell you the truth about you. He would tell you that you are not good. He will tell you if you are good, and he's not going behind you and telling that talk. He's telling you in your face. And so I remember this young lady that I was talking to. And I said, as I said before, we basically shared everything. I remember Jaja basically still in on this young lady. I went somewhere and he went into the house and the young lady had a beer together. And when I came back, they were still in the house. And so I realized that he was in the house, but I could not hate Jaja. You know why? Because he asked me before if I am that young lady is involved. And I said to him, no, because I was trying to protect the young lady's relationship. And so I did not war with him, but he would have mocked me, he would have cheered me, he would have said to our friends that, man, come on, you're a bad guy, come in. But you know, one of the main reasons I want to go in is because I said to the young lady that if you're there with your friend, me and you are at all. And so, just know that if we come in, me and the young lady are going to fight. And if not going to fight, me becomes the young lady. So you tell the young lady not to let me in. But not only that, years goes by, and Jaja still remember that night. So after the Lord Jesus Christ had called me and changed my life, I remember this moment when Jaja heard that I was going to church. He said to me that, "See, folks, what do you see? I got church." I said, "Yeah." And he said something to me, and I said to him that, "Listen to me, man. God called me. No man can't stop from doing what God wants me to do." And he said to me that, "See, you're really going to church, brother? You can't really stop, tough man, like you're really going to church. So what do you think you might never going to do now? You're going to be a fool." So I said to him that, "Listen to me, brother. Listen to me. If God called me, God called me. And God called me to be his servant, and I am going to be God's servant." But you know what I realized 3 days after? It's not that he didn't want me to serve God. He just did not know how to live without me being his friend, because we were a child, we were like friends from when we were 3 years old coming up. And so he would have missed that friendship that we had and we shared. And so today, I just want to say to the family members that are here, remember him as we know him to be, that kind, loving person and caring person. He loved his mom. He loved his mom. He loved his brothers. And I know that he loved his community. God bless you. God keep you. God make his face shine upon you and give you peace.
Sing the wondrous love of Jesus. Sing his mercy and his grace. After the singing of that song, we will have a eulogy from Arnie MacDonald. So please give an offering motion to the
After 2 years, we have a slight interest in construction. Due to his malformation, he became a student with a noble branch of the student company of Santa Cruz, where he learned different techniques in this. The other was a very loving and caring person. He would do various jobs to make sure he had money to give his mama Jane. Whenever she was broke, he would say, "All the enemies, don't worry, never get rich tonight." He was truly the most loving and caring one in the family. He showered his needs and needs with so much love. The first person to tell them how proud he is of them and to compliment them. He made sure to these things he knew that he was their biggest cheerleader and not to take any foolishness from the world. His favorite thing to say was, "Me, I'm a man who wants from some humility." Growing up in Cali, growing up in a challenging neighborhood, his words were valuable, and he was a big motivator. He made sure they were confident, knew their self-esteem, and made sure they also knew what he expected from them. Let's talk about him. He would take just about anything from home to give to someone who needs it. From sheep, clothes, food, anything you name it. It was never too big or small for him to use it. One of the biggest questions was that he really gave his life away to be shabby. He would get annoyed and let them know to pay for any benefit and to buy a nice clothes. Most of the time, he gives them clothes and shoes to wear until they go down to the back. He was the first in the family to travel to Mecca, and with his unselfish character, he helped his brother to cross and numerous other ways in the community to travel. Up to this day, many people have migrated from Homestead, from Jagasset, with Jagasset sisters. This was a huge achievement for him, and it still is. All of us know Ricardo Jagasset knew how fun he was, and how much he loved to dance and have a good time. So please, for him, for all of us, let's take a moment and shift our thoughts from how much we miss him to one of our own funny, joking, laughing, happy and glorified times that we share with him so easily. Receive it, enjoy and smile. Don't think that the judge has gone away. He's just begun life. He's just begun. Life falls off in the face. His heart is more than one. Just think of him as resting in sorrow of a tear, in a place of warmth and comfort where there are no days to fear. Think how he must be wishing that he could be here today while nothing but pride and sadness can be done in the past. And think of him as living and dying in our hearts of all those he has helped and coached. Jacqueline Mohammed, 7 brothers, 8 sisters, from a dog and son, nieces and nephews, family, relatives, and friends. Sleep in peace and heart, your family with peace, that your name is gone. I also have a tribute to hear it for someone. Okay, I'll finish one off.
Into Homestead one day. humanity in our society. And at some point, we have to think again as a people where this is concerned. It's not only for us just to gather in times like these when these things happen, put away another dead body and continue your lives. And then in another few months, you put away another one and you continue your lives. And for many of us, the impact of what is happening doesn't reach home until it actually reaches home. So today, I want you to think about what the psalmist says in Psalm 39, when he says, Lord, make me to know my end and the measure of my days, what it is that I may know of prayer. The reality that I want all of us today to fetch in our minds is this idea that our lives will one day end. We would wish, all of us, that our lives end laying in our beds comfortably, saying goodbye, farewell to all our family members, but that may as always be the lot of everyone. But what is important, really, is not so much how our lives end, but how we live our lives. It is what we do between our time of birth and death that really matters. And opportunities like these provide us with our situations like these provide us with the opportunity to reflect on our own lives and to use these occasions to recognize that we are all on this journey towards the prayer. The psalmist says, Lord, help me to know my end and the measure of my days. What it is that I may know how frail I am. The reality, ladies and gentlemen, it doesn't matter how strong we feel as humans, as men, as women, how invincible we feel as we get up every day and our hearts are beating and the blood is pumping through our veins and our faculties are in operation and we feel invincible. I want to remind all of you today that even those persons who have just received a clear bill of health from your doctor, that you have the best health ever, there is an end. There is an end. And the psalmist says, help me to know my end. The reality is that we don't live with the end in mind. The reality is that sometimes even occasions like funerals does no longer evoke in us a consciousness of the reality of our destination. But I want to speak into your hearts and lives this afternoon and say to you, ladies and gentlemen, I want you to reflect upon the fact that if you were the one whose body lying in this casket, what would have been your destination? The scripture said, help me to know my end and the measure of my days, what it is that I may know how frail I am. The reality, my brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, we live in this world and we acquire great things. Many of us, some of you sitting down here in front of me, you have great wealth and all of those things are things that are going great for you. You have a great career and all these things are going great for you. You look in the mirror each day and you look and you say, wow. And Solomon looks at that too and even more, and then he comes with this idea and he sums it up and he says, vanity of vanity. All is vanity. The reality, it doesn't matter what Ricardo possesses. The fact is that he is going to be laid in a grave this afternoon and he takes nothing with him. He brings nothing into this world and so surely he can take nothing out. We bring nothing into this world and surely we can take nothing out. But we can make our lives so impactful in the earth that it will leave a legacy for a long time and people will be edified. People will live a better life because of the contribution that we make to the world. Help me to know my end and the measure of my days.
that I may know how frail I am. My brothers and sisters, yes, we're told that we have 70 years to live. I recall it in the next 70 years. And by reason of strength, 80 years is allotted to humans, and some have gone beyond 80 years. But the reality still stands that you live 80 years, 85 years, 90 years, 95 years, 100 years. One day there will be an end. And the question will be, what did you do with all of that life that you lived from the start unto the end? My brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, Ricardo's death must not go in vain. It must be a turning point for the whole community. It must be a turning point for the family. It must be a turning point for the friends. It must be a turning point for all who knew him. This must be the day when this congregation said, the day that I buried my son, the day I buried my brother, the day I buried my friend, I turned. Because there is indeed an end. The psalmist wanted to know the end, that he may know how frail he was, that we too would be informed and well informed to know our end and to know how frail we are. So in a little while we're going to be going to the God to lay the body up and carry down. And all of the persons who travel there will leave his body there. And all the friends and everybody will leave this body there. And everyone will go on to their individual lives, and you will continue your lives. Because nobody's going to stay at the grave side with him. You will continue your lives, and you should continue your lives. But I want, as you continue your life, to remember, like the psalmist, that there is an end. And you must live your life. When your end actually occurs, you will be able to leave a legacy of something that can benefit the world. But also, when your end occurs, you will be able to find rest for your soul. And so, my brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, my encouragement to everyone here today who has never received Jesus in your heart as your personal Lord and Savior, I encourage you to think about it today on this 12th day of August in the year of our Lord 2022, when you also gave your life to Jesus because you want to make your calling and your election sure. You want to ensure that your end is secured in the Savior, the only one who can secure your lives. And so, Father, I thank you this afternoon that your word reminds us that there is indeed an end. And that your word calls us, Lord, to remember our end. And to remember how frail we are. To remember, Lord, that we too one day will find ourselves in this position as Ricardo is today. Help us then to live our lives, Lord, in a way that honors you and benefits humanity. That at the end of our lives, we too will leave a legacy that will last for generations. And even more importantly, we will find rest for our souls. I thank you, Lord, for your words today. Let it be etched in the minds of the hearer for a long time. And for those, Lord, who will open their hearts to you to receive you as their Lord and Savior, I pray that they shall do so today, and they shall make their appointment with you and your calling and election sure. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. I'm going to be praying for the family members. I'm going to ask you to stand, family members, so that we can stand with you. Sort of stand, family members, please, as we offer prayers for you. So Lord, I lift before you the family of Ricardo. You see their hearts. You know what is going on inside of them. Maybe there is anger, fear, trepidation, all kinds of different emotions all over the place. But I pray, Lord God, that you would honor them with your strength.
and with just power. I pray, Lord, that you would help them today to appreciate your goodness despite the challenges that they are confronting. I pray, Lord, that even though they are suffering grief and loss, they will not descend into a place of despair, but your strong hand will hold them up and will strengthen them and will encourage them as the journey continues for them in life. I thank you, Lord, that you will continue to be with them even throughout the days and weeks and months and years ahead, as you continue to preserve them, Lord. May today, Lord, be a real turning point in the family's life as a whole and in each individual, Lord. May day to day mark this as a day of turning, a day of change for the family as a whole. Bless them, I pray, and continue to keep your hand upon them, even as they grieve. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Thank you, Mr.
I've never been a king, so. All of them.
One more day, sir. One more day, sir. Sorry, let's show you a video, man. Let's show you a video, man. Let's show you a video, man. I get paid for this.
Let's go for the back of the
plate.
Five beer.
Alright,
hold the bottom of the box. Don't hold down. Hold the bottom of the box. Alright, that's the three. One, two, three. Lift.
Thank you.
How are you? Yes, I love, sir.
We don't not like.
Thank you, please. You know what
Shot box, that's it. And the energy. Looking good. A video.
Live stream from 20 months. Big up the man. Yeah, big up. Do let me sorry, say not there yet, but big up my friend.
I'm
not
Taffy, RIP, brother.
RIP, Taffy, yeah.
Oh. One Jaja.
Yeah. One Jaja.
Chat boss, yes sir.
You can talk, see me. Yeah, big up 20 yeah, months.
Man. You know what? You know me that one funeral now? But I get it tomorrow. Early morning, there's too much time. You said they can't get it. No, because I'm there. We are Spanish town. 9 o'clock in the morning. I leave, sir. That's when I link you, I left us. No problem.
Still running the streets cause every day I'm hustling. Double energy waiting in the streets is loving it. All this paper coming and my baby touching it. I'm gonna tell her why you love it.
Make sure me I get paid at me until the camera and ask me. You know so me happy video share still. My auntie, Baba, say hi.
When I reach, I don't want to, but it's not me.
Go ahead.
Fight so hard, try so hard, yeah. and it hurt me.
Really?
Them some here. Playing just chat too much, I didn't tell people there is some batty boy. In chat too much, man. Bumbo happy?
Yeah. Oh,
happy. Eh, Wally.
Can I come back?
Mm.
Okay. How
come on, take care. What
one, Rochelle?
So when come back?
Rochelle, I say your pussy.
Yeah. Big up, Jaja.
Big up, Jaja.
Andra, live stream. Yeah, catch this. Hello, family members. This is Miss Jacqueline. Jaja, see, a video man.
Andra!
Ariana, say something for your uncle. Somebody have a dead back. Marcella, I'm going to get you a one. I'm going to get you a one.
Watch your dolly them for Tony. Oh, say something to Tony Montana.
Big up to Tony Blood Club, Montana. Some people. One Jaja.
Better your uncle. Big up Jaja, Montana.
Sell me, like say me have a stone. We had the plug, no they wanna charge phone. Plane just crash with the cool. Plane just crash with the cool.
Cameraman have to pay me.
White like a Puerto Rican. Just call me and
say 120 Montana.
Playing the stress for the cold. I put it on the nose and sell me. Like say me have a stone. We had the block, now we want to charge for.
The cameraman have to pay me, alright?
Playing the stress for the cold.
He might be PM.
I think we're
like one extension 4x4. I'll be your man, may I do it? Anything for your uncle? Anything for your uncle?
One
God and badness. Cameraman have to pay him. Anything for Jaja. One cocky road.
Where your phone?
Me no know. A cameraman me hold it for.
I'm video in here, sir.
Yeah, that's the mama Jean.
Hey, where Akim and the girl there?
The girl there. Oh. Miss Jean, you're saying anything? One Jaja.
The gun finger.
One number.
She called
it
with the video.
To the one. Member.
The one number.
To the one. The one number.
One Georgia.
One boy with it.
Cameraman have to pay me one route. Watch out. So a man getting dressing from dad. The man. Watch it. Camera. Yeah. Girl, come out. Me no know. Bomba. Dali me. Cameraman have to pay me. Watch out, girl. Them come out for cocky route. But him got the wallet, you know? Rifle.
It's my video, everybody.
My turn to video, me.
The man I got pee at me and I just have to work with a light, Teresa. Uncle needs
you. Real killer. And a sweet pepper. Make it gun beat like rhythm from a beat maker. Some of the yaffy die back.
I cameraman give you full. Yeah, sister.
R.I.P. to a real killer.
Thank you.
Look at the blood clot.
Cause if you don't know, you're not going to clutch on me. Only never change my mind, I'm not changing. If I'm someday, yeah, yeah, yeah. Look at my step, I'm better than my
I'm not lying, I'm not hot. Dolly friend, Dolly in a real life. You look good, don't run. I came around man tempe video, everybody. You win, sister. Yeah, watch out. Yeah. Boy! But tired, the girl them come out.
Get to yourself, get to yourself.
My name, let me get fire. Give me this. They're ready. I picture man, me I work for.
R.I.P. to a real killer. Real killer, real killer. Head, pop, suck!
touchy and a sweet pepper. Make it gun beat like rhythm from a beat maker. So my day I feel dead back, feel me feel better. Who no better afraid of me dog? The bang of them ready and a weird pan a call. Put in top oxy and pure gun metal. The clip them full but no waste none at all. Drive up them run almost tear down a wall. Rifle open doors no spear none at all. Left some of the mama lay down a ball. Give the pussy them a funeral. Ballman solo. R.I.P. to a real killer. Yeah, R.I.P. to a real killer. R.I.P. to a real killer. Yeah, real killer, real, real, real. Yeah. What thing going on that? Got a friend, pussy. Bad man, Salo. R.I.P. to a real killer. R.I.P. to a real killer. R.I.P. to a real killer. Real killer, real, real, real killer. Hey, I'm scotchy and a sleep pepper. Make it gun beat like rhythm from a beat maker. Somebody my day I feel dead back, feel me feel better. Who no make a friend of me dog? The bang of them ready and now we have an call. Two things to oxy and pure gun metal. The clip them full but no waste none at all. Drive up them run almost dead on a wall. Rifle open but it's not still on a wall. Let somebody know what lay down a wall. Give me pussy them a funeral. Bad man shallow. R.I.P. to a real. R.I.P. to a real.
I don't know a cartel on the poor boy fire day, Rizla. If a posters, if a video, are you with Aya? So we say Mali.
Mali! Mali! You are the boss!
Fire song, are you alone player, I wanna say, hear that? Watch and shush, 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 shush. Can you hear me?
This a Jim Brown story, West Kingston story, Garden Man story, shush, shush, shower man story. Hey! I remember those days when Father Jim was around. I him set the yard as a West Kingston. From your miss Father Jim, make me hear the ting sound. Put your hand in a the ear and show
Jim Brown.
I remember when the pussy them tried to Jim for clown. Them a fi put barricade on circuit courthouse a town. Pound walk on a police tried to jatty crown. A the first missy police boy get boxed down.
I remember Father Jim lead down the shower gang. 300 man strong go take over Fletcher's land.
I remember the Chinese man with him gas station, posing front the dan, but him oh chang chang.
I remember when the mafia run we go Hong Kong. I never know such a woman reside in I'm land.
I remember Claudia must of respect to Vivian.
Fathers give them a foundation. Mr. President, we up with kingdom. We never lose none. Kingfish running and still never find none. The mafia wonder how we lack so much gun. Ra, ra,
no,
ra,
no, no,
ra,
ra.
We not
no nice.
Farms, so
no nice.
We. Them can't use them crime stop and beat way. Because the whole of garden they live greatly. Ra, ra, ra.
I remember July 7th, Jamaica explode. When Adams and him squad block Spanish Town Road. Panty Valley outskirts with them guns well load.
A pure madman them kill on the road.
I remember when we stick the poll clerks and dump the ballot box Panty the outskirts.
Silent! Blood, blood, double nice! Double nice!
Now the whole me alerts. I remember Zion Train. I remember Bagaba. I remember Chris Royal, the real outlaw. Said I'm a power pick king, give your gun shot. No informer can live a Java. Prezi used to go out the nice school. Over Excelsior live up, learn the golden rule. Now them turn big man, I bust them old tool. No boy can take show, I'm on them for fools. So we up with kingdom, we never.
All our iron boxes show. Unisa show!
Wab.
A show. What is a show?
Soon for them then. Kill nobody.
Let's see if you can wheel, you know.
I got you for those. Come now, come now.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Easy man, you have pressed too hard, brother. Easy. Yeah, where you go, sir, G?
Come here.
Ease out. You.
Yeah, you're good, man. Mega! Bombe!
Push up a one, man. Well, you know, name go bear me, let's see.
just to express our interest. But on the whole, we're up.
Please give me some space now, thank you. Please give me some space.
Now turn this man into destruction and says, return ye children of men, for a thousand years in thy sight are as yesterday when it is past, and as the watch of the night. Thou carriest them away and with the flood. They are asleep. In the morning they are like grass which groweth up. In the morning it flourisheth and groweth up. In the evening it is cut down and withereth. For we are consumed by thine anger, and by thy wrath we are troubled. Thou hast set our iniquities before thee, our secret sins in the light of thy countenance. For all our years are passed away in thy wrath. We spend our years as a tale that is told. The days of our years are 80 years, and if by reason strength they be 80 years. Yet is there strength and labor and sorrow, for it is soon cut off, and we fly away. Lord, make me to know my end and the measure of my days, what it is that I may know how frail I am. Behold, thou hast made my days as a handbreadth, and mine age is nothing before thee. Verily, every man at his best day is altogether vanity.
Jesus! We're not a body!
We sing together.
Oh,
when the road is long, we are
together.
Yes, I just do.
Jesus, 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 Jes by the river.
Meet me by the river. Not far away. Oh, when I love you, I'll help you on the other side. I'll help you.
Yeah.
Pop Squad, we had a move. Now go upload it right now, don't worry about it. Church is a little problem, you see me? You never come out here, man.
You
never come out here, man. You right here, man. And then tell him to go back down here outside.
Yeah. Alright.
All right.